We're on Act Two. Pepper explores Philadelphia, her kooky colonist, and one bogus Ben. Okay, we're supposed to find British Taxation Act. I thought that the watch was hired by the... I didn't truth it. I guess you should just truth everything. Millinery shops? Ben Franklin's influence on the colonial post office? The Penn family? Potholes. Meet the colonists. Meet Ben Franklin. All right. Okay, I think this is a truth one. This is one of the silliest human beings I've ever seen. False. There were no hippies in Philadelphia at this time in history, particularly not disc-tossing hippies. Oh, this is the Stamp Act. 20% toll on salt, sugar, molasses, rutabagas, chocolate, toys, clothing, and anything else for the honorable plus find interesting or tasty. It will also cost citizens 1 shilling to pass any and all stamp tax styles. Signed, General Hugh Pugh II, acting governor of Philadelphia. Was his name really Hugh Pugh? Is that true? Ridicule is often a part of punishment in colonial America. In addition to being put in the village, the stocks and labeled a village idiot, the prisoner was often pelted with rotten vegetables and things by his or her neighbors, and you thought detention was a bummer. You love this game? It's a good game so far. Let's use the truthometer. False. There were some redcoats in the colonies at the time, but not that many. A large number of troops were withdrawn from the colonies after the French and Indian War, or Seven Year War, ended in 1763. It was just too expensive to keep them there. Colonial governor might have had redcoats to guard his private estate, but probably not. He sure wouldn't have anyone as silly as these guys. Excuse me, sir, but I'd like to go into the mansion. I'm a delivery boy. Oh, is that right? What are you delivering? Air? Nice fresh air, see? How in that case go- Hey, wait a minute! There's no such thing as an air delivery boy! Oh well, it's worth a try. Excuse me, sir, but I wonder if you'd hand me that string in the tree. Oh, why do you want what to do with kite string, you little wretch? Oh, he's going to wear it in his pretty hair. Oh, no, no. We use it to keep his pants on his scrawny bum. Ha ha. Laugh while you can, lobster boys. Everybody knows the Americans win at the, in the end. Ha ha. He's not just obnoxious, he's balmy. There you go, you silly little twit. Don't strangle yourself now. You wouldn't hate living in this time period? No internet! No internet, come on. No internet, no games, no computers. No toothpaste? Stay away from the river, you little water rat! Stay away! My head is so big! Look at how big my head is! It's huge! I have such a huge head! Anyway... Whoops. Keep pushing the wrong button. Don't try it, little laddie! I can't be bribed! You don't have any gold or mutton, do you? Afraid not. Like I said, I can't be bribed. You know, what if we just, like, walk across? Hey, who's this? There were really, okay, yeah, we already got that one. What if we just try and walk across the bridge? Ah, where do you think you're going? Halt! Halt, I say! Well, I was just going to... Going to what, you young scallywag? The general doesn't want any grubby urchins on his property. He doesn't! Hey, who are you calling grubby? Well, you little wretch, now off with you. Okay, so I have to apparently have some less wretchy clothes. Oh, wait, I can go down? Where's that go? Oh, same place. Can I go this way? Oh, I can go this way. Oh, I'm supposed to meet the colonists. That's right. The colonists would probably be this way. Ooh. But you have to see my point, don't you? I mean, even someone as pig-headed as you can understand that. Pig-headed? Me, pig-headed? You could out-stubborn a mule, baby! Are you calling me a mule, are you? You should talk. If either of us looks like an animal, it's you. Oh, and what kind of animal is that, my dearest darling? I can hardly wait for you to share your wisdom with me. A weasel! Just look in the mirror at those beady eyes and pointy nose. I'm surprised you don't sneak into hen houses at night. Well, that was most uncool of you. Especially coming from someone who looks like a fish. Most uncool. Yeah, I'm sure they were saying that back then. A fish? Well, I never. Okay, that's just not true. There were many hopeful young clergymen in training in the vicar colonies, including vicar wannabes. Many colonial parents hoped their sons would become clergymen instead of doctors or lawyers. Okay, what's this? I feel like this is something. Tax notice. We know the Stamp Act. Citizens will be taxed accordingly. Okay, we already know this. What's this? It's a bag. What's in the bag? It's a bag full of small round objects. Marbles. It's got marbles in it. We got a bag of marbles. A bag of marbles. A bag of marbles. Who's out there? I hear someone walking out there. Oh, no, an urchin. I beg your pardon, man, but I'm not a creature of the sea. Don't give me any lip, you young scoundrel. I know an urchin when I see one. Get off the street, you hear? Go home. I'd really like them too, man, but you see, that's the problem. Don't waste your sob story on me, little man. I really don't want to hear it. Now go on, scat! Well, wasn't she charming? Sheesh. Hey, here's the millery shop. Oh, we get points for that? I didn't know that. Collins' millinery shop sold wigs and hats. They always did good business. Though, since hats were part of everyday dress and many people like to imitate the fashions of France by wearing wigs. I didn't know we got points for that. Well, I guess we should go back and like click on those taxation acts, right? It had nothing to do with tax styles and certainly nothing to do with rutabagas. Okay. Actually, the Stamp Act was just one of the many unfair tax laws passed by the British. Other laws, including the Navigation Act, which restricted trade routes, and the Molasses Act, which was a high tax on molasses, and Sugar Tax, which was a high tax sugar. It's amazing that the British never got around to passing a Salt Act. Maybe we can go in the shop. Probably not, though. Hello! Oh, it's a fine young boy. May I help you, lad? Oh boy, I don't know where to start, man. I'm lost in time. The pubes stole my dog. I need to see Ben Franklin, and I don't know what to do. Now just relax, laddie. My name is Tattle Tale Teller, and I know everything about everyone. Just tell me what you need to know. Ask about what exactly is going on with Ben Franklin. I heard he wasn't feeling well. Ben is perfectly fine. After all, he did give that excellent doctrine of personal mellowness and all that, but it's not the whole story, no sir. I heard that Ben and his wife Deborah are having problems. Yes, sir. She's always leaving the house to go somewhere. Was Ben Franklin married? Is that true? Some people say she's seen another man. Some people say it's that poor Richard, but I'd never say anything like that, no sir. Tell me, Miss Tattle Teller, have the pews always been this rotten? Oh yes, when old Pew was there, things were even worse. I guess we're just lucky that Hugh Pew the Second spent so much time powdering his wig instead of making us miserable. Yes, Pepper is pretending. All we have to do is wear some trousers. Yeah, we've got some trousers and basically boy clothes. That awful Emma Pugh stole my dog. Have you heard anything about that? Oh my, yes, I heard a little while ago that Pugh's got a new dog. I'm so sorry, little boy. You'll forget about him in no time. What do you mean? I can't forget Lockjaw. He's my best friend. Oh, didn't you know? Dogs who go to Penn's Mansion never come out, dearie. At least not the same way. Oh no. So tell me about yourself, Miss Telltale Teller. Aren't you sweet? Well, I'm a very highly respected member of this community. Some people call me a gossip, but that's not true. Nellie at the sewing shop says I'm a gossip, but what do you expect from someone who drove her husband to an early grave by scolding him so much? Penny calls me a gossip too, but she's just jealous because she owes debts and I don't. And I don't believe General Lee stuffed either. And don't believe General Lee stuffed either. He doesn't like me because I know he got a dishonorable discharge from the army. Anyway, I'm not a gossip. Okay. That's it. Thanks. What else am I supposed to look for? Ben Franklin influence on the colonial post office, the Penn family, and potholes. Oh, potholes. Colonists, life is often difficult. Luxury items are highly priced. Boutiques that... No, I want to look at the road. Okay, well, maybe it's over here. Potholes. How do I... Oh, it's an arrow. Derp. Derp. Oh, there's a pothole. Let's look at that one. The streets of the colonies were often neglected because of the lack of organization and manpower. The potholes in Boston where Ben Franklin grew up were particularly bad. In fact, when Ben was only 16, he wrote a funny letter to his brother's paper under the name of Silence Do-Good, asking if the potholes were there on purpose. If so, he said they were a great favor to the flies and the pigs who loved to wallow there. The letter shamed the town council into having the potholes filled. Ha! Ha! Hilarious. Hey, go that way. Let's go into Ye Old Sprout and Rice, which is open. That sounds... Ew, what's that? Swarm of pesky flies are blowing above Goody's shop. So we found potholes, British Taxation Acts, millinery shops. Green cookies, I don't think so. Goody. Do you suppose I could have this jar?
Well, that's a bit tough, child. I'm afraid I can't give it away, but if you were to bring me something in trade...
I know.
Bring me a recipe for chocolate bonbons, and the jar is yours. It's a deal, goody. Chocolate, okay. That's a weird request. Hello, ma'am. I wonder if you could help me. Certainly, child. What do you need? Some soy flour? Some tofu? A green cabbage? A nice cabbage cookie, perhaps? Ugh. No, excuse me, ma'am. That was kind of involuntary. What I meant was, no thank you. Well, you don't seem to be affected by the mass lunacy that's plagued this colony. I believe you actually shuddered at the mention... of tofu. It was the cabbage cookies that made me shudder, man. But you're right. I haven't been affected by it. You haven't either, have you? No, thank heavens. Nice to meet you. I'm Goody Gumdrops, and I own this nice, fine establishment. If there's anything I can do for you, let me know. Actually, there is. I wonder if you could answer a few questions for me. Oh, my. Well, I'll certainly do my best. What do you want to know? I have reason to believe that Ben Franklin is responsible for the weirdness going on here. Is that true? It is. He came into town dressed like a fool, all covered in beads. Then he started passing out his foolish doctrine of personal mellowness. My friends and neighbors believed it. Before I knew it, they were all dressed like Ben Franklin. Then they started talking strangely. Everything was groovy. And it got worse. They all stopped working and developed bad habits almost instantly. Now they're all as worthless as a bunch of lame oxen. Yeah, I know. Everybody's head is misshapen. You seem like a sensible lad. You should go to Ben's house and try to talk him out of this foolishness. Maybe you have more luck than I did. Okay, let's do that. Let's do truth. Nobody made cabbage cookies in colonial times, or ever! We sincerely hope nobody does now, but there's this one little place in Berkeley that we strongly suspect. Many foods were pickled, canned, or otherwise preserved in colonial times, so they would last longer. I don't know what that is supposed to mean. Any establishment that would serve food would attract flies, or maybe Goody just needs a shower. Ben Franklin invented the rocking chair. It was an instant success. He even invented a rocking chair that had a fan attached. One newspaper man, however, had this to say about the classic invention. Mr. Ben Franklin has invented a rocking chair? Shame on you, Ben. Almost all persons are lazy enough now. A chair that rocks will ruin the rest of us. This is not a gift of mankind, dear sir. So as far as we know, the rocking chair has yet to destroy civilization. That wasn't something I was supposed to look for. But okay. There were bakeries in colonial America, but they didn't carry sprouts and rice. Uncle Fred strikes again. Simpsons. Where's his house, by the way? It must be up here. Must be this way. Let's go up here. Doop-a-doo. Oh, Homer the Inventor, yeah. You know how hard I laughed at that shotgun in the makeup gun? Man! That's so funny. So, we let people go past the stile, but only after we've given them money? No, you fool! You take money from people. You don't give them money. You tell them it's part of the stamp tax, and you take their money. Okay, sir, I get it. Get what? Look, you fat-witted, bean-brained idiots. People pass through the gate, you take their money, then they go. You tell them it's part of the stamp tax. That's it. That's all, nothing more. Here now, you're not the brightest lights in the outhouse, but we're not stupid. We demand money from people that wants to go through the gate, right? Yes, precisely. And then we can pocket it, like... No, that money is mine. You keep one half penny of it, and I'll see you hung from the tallest building in Philadelphia. That would be Nelly's shop, wouldn't it, Monty? No, it's the General's Mansion, Cecil. Ugh. See here, man, just remember it this way. Take it all, big or small, take it to the General's Hall. Take it all, big or small, take it to the General's Hall. Ooh, I like it. That's got a ring to it. It does. Finally, carry on, you worthless ninny hammers. You're lucky I came up with that rhyme for them to say. The money had better start rolling in, Percy, or I'll have you all boiled in oil. Yes, sir, I'm sure it will, and if I do say so, it was a nice touch putting the style right in front of Ben Franklin's house, sir. Yes, it was brilliant of me. The colonists won't fight the tax when they see that Ben won't lift a finger to get it off his front lawn. Ha! If you want to pass, laddie, you must pay the tax. Right, pay the tax! Pay the tax, huh? And just what is this tax going to? New roads? New schools? Ah, the General's wig collection, most likely. Hush up, you fool! Who are you, anyway, you nosy lad? I don't think I've seen you before. I am what I am, dude, which is more than I can say about you. Huh? Stop, your brilliance is blinding. Now here, I think you're insulting me. He's insulting you, Cecil. Well, stop it. The price for you to pass is a whole shilling, you little smart aleck. Shilling is one British coin. 20 shillings equals one British pound. A shilling and that's final. Redcoats weren't. Oh yeah, okay. Stamp tax had nothing to do with toll roads or textiles. Okay. Well, with them here, what does that mean? The hedge is really thick and tangled. There's no way I could crawl through it. So I need to get a shilling. Or I need to do something else. Since they're there, are they no longer over here? Like, I can't double click. I could up the speed. Up the game. They are still here. Okay, they're in two places at the same time. Alright, whatever. We're supposed to go to Ben Franklin's house, though, so I feel like we can go back in the alley. Doesn't look like there's anything to get over here. And the hole is gone, also. It's interesting. Can we go back in here? Tearing out the stamp pack notes might be fun, but it's almost certainly to get Pepper arrested. And thrown in the stocks. Well, I don't want to get thrown in the stocks. That's for sure. Okay, so we get points for that. Is that a point sound? Would you call that a point sound? Like, it doesn't give us points, but it's definitely a point sound, right? I need to get my my audio thing so I can record these when they happen. You know, I need to record the sounds. There's like 2 point sounds in this one. Isn't that a sound from another game? Bop 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 bop. Isn't that the same sound or a similar sound, like Quest for Glory or something? What the heck is going on here? Pay the tax, huh? Just what is... Okay, we already had that dialogue. Well. I think I might turn up the speed a little bit. Let's see if we can talk to them. Excuse me, sir, but why are you in such a bad mood? Are you upset about Hugh's rampant tyranny? No, no, nothing like that. I'm just trying to convince this stubborn woman that I didn't lose her stupid hair ribbon. Oh, there's a good reason to call something fish, someone fish face. You tell him, little boy, he's a brute. Give it a rest, Quibby. What do you want anyway, you little troublemaker? I believe that Ben Franklin is under the influence of a what-if machine and may not be in his right mind. You know anything about that? That's not true. He's perfectly fine. In fact, he's the one who told us that quarreling is healthy. Well, if that's true, you must be the healthiest couple in all of Philadelphia. So what's a what-if machine anyway? Well, it's this big, spinning, whirling sort of... you see, my Uncle Fred, what it does is take time and space and... Oh, never mind. I'm beginning to wonder if you're in your right mind, little boy. General Pugh's daughter stole my dog, Vicar. Have you heard anything about him? Well, what does your dog look like? He's a little white dog with a tough expression and lots of teeth. Have you seen him? No, the last dog I saw was out of Penn's mansion was a green poodle. Poor little thing. I think they took him away. I heard he went loony. Well, you exaggerate all the time, Vicar. Don't believe in little boy. No, no, it's true. You'd better rescue your dog before it's too late, little boy. Okay, let's just go again. Could you tell me something about yourself, sir? Sure, little boy. I'm Vicar Bicker. And I travel the streets of Philadelphia spreading peace and love. Oh, all you ever spread is butter on biscuits, Victor. You've never seen a human creature eat as much as you do. At least I stay thin, dearest. And just what do you mean by that? Oh, nothing, dear. Excuse me, miss, but what has caused you and your boo here to argue so bitterly? Is it politics? Money, perhaps? Oh, no, it's much more important than that. He lost one of my hair ribbons. Can you believe it? Did not. Shut up, dearest. So what do you want anyway, little boy? What is your name, Miss Quarrelsome Colonist? I'm Quibble Quabble. And this thing is the love of my life, Vicar Victor Bicker. I can speak for myself, dearest. Put a cork in it, dearest. Oh, man. I have reason to believe that Ben Franklin is still under some kind of influence. He is even disturbed and deranged. Do you know anything about that? Oh, Ben's not disturbed. He's really cool. He's the one who taught us to let our feelings out. Ben? Cool? You like him, don't you, Quimby? You have a crush on Ben Franklin. I knew it. I just knew it. Hello? Why don't you come and live with this in this world, Victor? Ben is married. Jeez. So it's true that the Pews are running roughshod over the colony of Philadelphia and no one is willing to stop them? Hey, there's a pain and all. They're a pain and all, but most of us have our own problems. We don't have time to save the world from British generals, you dig? What, you're too busy doing your nails? You have no sense of social injustice, Quimby? Quibby? Not Quimby. Oh, go tell it to the chickens in the hen house, weasel boy. I did all of these, right? My dog Lockjaw has been kidnapped by the Pews, miss. I don't suppose you've seen him. No, I'm afraid I haven't seen any dogs around here lately. The Pews get them all, I think. Not that she would have noticed, even if your dog walked up and bit her. The chick is so into herself, she can't get past her own nose. Oh, who asked you? All right, well... I need to figure out how to get past the thing. Yeah, I wonder if you could help me out. Okay, we've already had this dialogue. Okay. The store, health conscious? Heavens no, you could get away, you could get anything you wanted here, from strawberry tea cakes to airy cream puffs, chocolate bonbons. Mmm. When the town went mad, they stopped eating sugar. All they wanted was tofu and brown rice. They burned my bonbon recipe. They even made me change the name of my store from Goodies Delectable Delights to Ye Olde Sprouts and Rice. I can't even get chocolate anymore. Oh, how I miss the smell of baking chocolate. The dog Lockjaw, my dog Jockdog, I kidnapped. The pews just rolled up in their carriage and snapped shut. What do you suppose I should do? Oh, you poor, poor child. I don't know how to tell you this. Tell me what? You can make it. I can take it. I'm a reporter. Lad, you may never see your doggy again. The pews have an evil reputation for taking poor pooches in the night and doing things to them. What kind of things, ma'am? You don't want to know, child. You really don't want to know. But I do want to know.
Sweet, merciful crap!
I need a bonbon recipe. Where would I get a bonbon recipe? She said they burnt it. Can I, like, I can't go out the back way, can I? No, I can't. Okay. Now, I haven't tried going in there yet. Whoops. Try it. What do we need to do? We played them all. We played them once. We did actually play the Hoyle games once. So, we have done that before. We played, maybe I could do a Home Alone. I enjoy Jeopardy also. I like both the bad answers. Wait, is there a way up here that we haven't gone? Oh, there is. There's another way. Oh, well, here you go. Excuse me, sir, did you say you were a gamer? Indeed I am, lad. I am Ronald Betmuch. Or Roland Betmuch. And games are my life. Interested in a game of chance or a game of skill? Poker, perhaps? Oh, drat. Those uncool plues took my deck of cards. Darts? No. They took those two. Let's see. What do I have? Jacks? No. Chess? No. Checkers? No. Horseshoes? No. Hey, I know. Do you have a horse? No, but total bummer. My aura is turning. Oh wait, I know. We'll play marbles. I've got them right here. Ah, what? I lost my marbles. You could say that again. If you buy my marbles, let me know, okay? Later, Cosmic Cat. Oh yeah, I did. Here you go. Hey, Roland, I found you this bag of marbles. They may be yours, but they may not be. I don't suppose you'd be interested in buying them. You aren't a little sharpie, are you? You are a little sharpie, aren't you, kid? I'll tell you what. I'll give you the marbles, and I'll teach you to gamble with the best of them. I don't think so. I'm a reporter, not a gambler. I want cash. I want cash for marbles, bud. Cash? Kid, where's the sport in that? Where's the action? Where's the thrill of the game? Don't you have the heart, the game in your heart? Nope, I've got air in my wallet. Now fork over the bucks, bud. Oh, all right, here's a shilling. It's all I have, you little robber. Thanks. Now go fly a kite. Man, I didn't capture that. I wanted to, but I didn't. There's a post office at Colonial America. Ben Franklin was the first postmaster of Philadelphia. I don't think we need to do anything here. Excuse me, sir, but I wonder if you could help me with something. What? Nope. Why? Cuz? What does that mean, cuz? Could you, like, pull, like... Would you like me to pull that mail sack right out from under you, your lazy hide? Nope. Then just answer a few questions for me, okay? Okay. I've heard some distressing rumors about Ben Franklin lately. Seems he's not himself. Is that true? Beats me. Why don't you pay attention to what goes on in your own town? Nope. Why not? Beats me. Look, Heidel, the pews committed an act of blatant larceny right in front of my eyes. I'm not going to take that lying down, are you? Yup. You're disgraceful. If everybody was like you, nothing would ever get done in this world, you know? I know. You just don't care, right? Exactly. I don't think we're gonna get anything from this person. Brain cramp. So, mister, what's your name again? Heidel? Yup. Suits you perfectly, dude. Thanks. Pepper doesn't want to take the notice down. Well, what does it say? The notice says, by order of me and His Royal Majesty King George III, whoever has been writing me nasty letters had just better stop. I am not a doily draped, perfume-drenched fop. When I catch you, you're in big trouble. Signed, General Hugh Pugh II. Aha! That is funny. Okay, what haven't we found yet? We found the Penn family. Who's that? Who's the Penn family? There are no hippies. No hippies. All right, now we can get to Ben Franklin because we have the shilling to pay. Bring it all, big or small. Hey yo, you big red goon. Well, thank you very much, you smart mouth street urchin. Yon old gentleman is a right nutter, you know, and his wife will toss you out on your ear. Remember, you'll need another shilling to get past the other way. Ha ha ha. Right, another one. Ha ha. Well. I want to look this up. Oh, Ben Franklin was married. Ben Franklin was married, apparently, to Deborah Franklin. But they spent all but two of their final 17 years apart. So... But biographers and historians tend to shy away from his married life because it defies idealization. Apparently, Ben and Deborah's marriage defies idealization. Meanwhile, back in Penn Mansion... Oh, this is the Penn family. There's no toy I haven't got. Throw a tantrum. It gets bought. Is my name. Yeah, 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 yeah. And I'm rich and I'm a star and I don't really care. Love all doggies, big and small. Shave them. Dress them like a doll. Glue their paws to parasols. Ima is my name. Oh, my little Snooky Wookums. Mama's naming you Fluffy. Does him like his new name? Phew, Fluffum smells bad. Him's a dirty birdie. Yes, him is. Does Mama's little Sweetums want his bathy wathy? The nice man will be in soon to give Snookums his itty-bitty bath. Mama's gonna shop for Snookums treats now. Yes, she is. Don't cry, because I'll be back soon, Huggy Bunny. Huggy Bunny. Yeah, I do think that's what that means, Gregory. Oh, I'm on the dog now! 7. The dog in Penn Manor. We just like ate the bone. Gritting his teeth against the nasty smell of the butler, Lockjaw takes a drink. Do it again. What's that sound off in the distance? Oh, it's the call of nature. We peed on stuff! Take that! Can't reach up that high. You doubt the clock would smell very good anyway. Nice doggy, good doggy. Here's a little flea. That's a little a good little flea bit. But now, easy, you ugly little hound. Come here, you horrid canine. Should we bite him? The butler is a tall, lanky fellow. Lockjaw thinks a good bite in the posterior would do him a world of good. Okay. Deal. Lockjaw decides to give the butler an attitude adjustment. Lockjaw doesn't believe his eyes. Did the bookcase just spin around? Oh no. You'll not have any more of that. I'm not paid well enough to wash wild hyenas. I'm not. I don't care what Miss Ima does to me. Get wrecked. Hey, the Star Gamer. How's it going? I didn't see you there. And now I do. Kind of invested in the game. Just a bit. Can we truth stuff? Swiss clocks remained cuckoo clocks for hundreds of years. They were very expensive in colonial times, as they are now. So only very wealthy families could afford them. This cuckoo clock may not be what it seems, however. Doctor would love to knock the dolls off the shelf, but he can't reach them. Pepper always tells Lockjaw not to chew up clocks with his mouth full. Lockjaw decides to sample the brass pine cone on the cuckoo clock. That's what I thought was gonna happen. See, we're a genius. I'm a genius. Secret passage. Secret. We found a secret.
Right. I am too smart. I am too smart.
S-M-R-T.
I mean, S-M-A-R-R-T.
The hell? Oh, no. Let's use the truth thing. Pet cemeteries were just about unheard of in colonial times. Certainly no one put dog memorials in their closets. The brass plaque at the collar says, "My beloved Fluffum Foo, all I did was shampoo you, shave your paws, pierce your nose, put rings upon your little toes. So why, oh why did you run away and jump into the sea that day?" Muffy was a spaniel. Muffy was a pup. Ima went to Muffy's house and scooped the doggy up. Ima scalloped Muffy's ears and shaved off all her hair, so Muffy climbed up on the roof and dove off in despair. Brass plaque reads, "A poodle named Muffet sat on a tuffet covered with shampoo and whey. Along came Miss Ima with fur bleach and china, and Muffet just faded away." Oh my god. "There once was a doggy named Jot who was spied by Miss Ima and caught. She painted him pink and draped him with mink, and he died of shame on the spot. Fuzzy Wuzzy was a dog. Ima dressed him like a frog, and then she threw him in the lake. He couldn't swim, for heaven's sake." Brass plaque reads, "An itsy bitsy Yorkie came into Ima's yard. Ima grabbed the Yorkie and spiked his hair with lard. The Yorkie ran around the room, squealing like a hog. Then the itsy bitsy Yorkie vanished in the bog." Holy crap. That's not good. It looks like a rat hole. You think I can go in the rat hole? No, I can't go. Maybe I can dig it. Dig the rat hole. Okay, can't do it. Okay, let's put the, put the fleas in the hole. No. Where'd my bone? Didn't I get that bone? Where'd the bone go? I apparently ate it. Apparently ate the bone. It's gone now. Oh. Ew. Lockjaw smells a rat. He chews through the wood. Okay, that works. This is quite the dog. What's that? Lockjaw can see people just beyond the fire. Oh, it's a fireplace.
Something.
Percy, how is the tax operation going? Are you keeping those stupid sentries in line? They don't know the stamp tax is fake, do they?
No, sir, General Pugh. They have no idea.
Good, if they told the colonists the stamp act hasn't been made law, things might get ugly. How much money have we taken so far? Oh, sir, scads and oodles. I'd say half the town has been wrung dry, and the other half is still slightly damp, sir. Good, my wigs aren't cheap, and my little Ima must have whatever she wants. Oh, Percy, remind me to beat you for letting Ima have that horrible mutt. Yes, sir, you should beat me, sir. That's all my fault. Blasted right, you should have. You just better not slip up again, you miserable toady.
I want you to keep an eye on Ben Franklin in case he decides to get out of that oversized washtub. I don't want anything interfering with our plans. Yes, sir. Sir, there's a teeny tiny weeny itty bitty minuscule problem. Percy, you know I hate that word. I must have to strangle. I might just have to strangle you. Well, what's this problem? Poor Richard, sir. He's been trying to rile up the colonists. Talks a lot like Ben Franklin did before he lost his mind. He's dangerous, sir. You should have anticipated this, you fool. Take care of him, Percy, or your neck will go on the chopping block. Go! Yes, sir. And now, sir. All right, we're back here now. We're back here. Save. Ben Franklin's. At Ben's. Good afternoon, Miss Franklin. I'd like to see Ben Franklin, please. No. But Miss Franklin, I really need to see him. I have a terrible problem. No. But you don't understand. My dog's been kidnapped by the Pews. Please, I need Mr. Franklin's help to get him back. Lad, I'm sorry about your dog. There was a time when Ben could have helped you, but
I'm
not now.
Landing.
Not now. He can't even help himself. He's gone around the bin, filling the colonists' heads with all sorts of funny mush. I'm allowing him no visitors. If I let you in to see him, he'd just be a bad influence on you two. But, if you could help Ben get him interested in his experiments, perhaps I'd let you in. I'm sorry, but I have to leave you now. Goodbye. Okay. I'm gonna knock again. I've no need that, lad. Okay. Let's go with truth. Ben Franklin married Deborah Reed on September 1st, 1730. That's what we got. But they don't tell you that they spent the final 17 years other than two apart. So, you know. Mr. Franklin, I could be a good influence on the plan. I know a lot of cool things I would tell him. I tell great jokes, and all the more reason for you to stay away from him. If you go in there, all that dazzling wit of yours will go right out with the bathwater. I'm telling you, he's become dangerous to the public health. Go away. Good day, lad. Okay. Take it to the General's Hall. Casey, so where's the General Hall? That means Penn's Mansion, you fool. Right, but if it means a particular hall in Penn Mansion, like the main hall, the upstairs hall, the hall that leads to the loo. Good day, gents. It's quite a hall. It's big, not small. Yeah, I suppose it is. Let's hope the General Hall is not too small. It wouldn't be, now would it, unless it's the one that leads to the loo. To store it all, you may need a mall. Oh, blast. What did Percy Throttlebottom tell us to do again? Let's see. Take a ball, throw it on the general's wall. No, wait, that's not it. Take a ball, not take a doll to take it. That's take it all to the general's hat. Well, you better stop confusing us, right? You know, of the seasons all, I like the fall. It's when the trees grow and sweet and tall. It is nice, isn't it? All those lovely colors. Don't talk to him, Monty. He's trying to confuse us. No, not at all. I just want you to tell you all about the amazing General's Ball. A ball, really? Oh, I love to dance. I'm quite the, quite a devil with the ladies, I am. They say the ball is big, not small. Hey, we weren't invited to no ball. Yeah, we weren't invited. Here, a hairpiece big and tall, and you shall dance at the General's Ball. I just need to wear a wig, and then I can go? Well, then, I look dashing in a wig. Big and tall, I like that! Oh, wear a wig, ye, in the fall. Wear a wig, both big and tall. You, too, shall dance at the General's Ball. A wig in the fall, big and tall, to get to the General's Ball? Got it. Hey, Cecil, there's a wig shop in town. There is. But we don't have any money, Monty. Oh, dear. You've got lots of money, Percy said. Take it all, big or small. Buy a wig at Downtown Mall. Right, that is what he said. We got lots of money, we do. What are we waiting for? Right, but I get the biggest and tallest wig, though. Says you, let's hurry before they're all gone. I had to do it. It was too easy. Well, they opened the gate, too. Nice, and they left what we're gonna use as a kite. Hey, they left something behind. I wonder what it is. It's a piece of tin. I guess I hang on to it. It looks like a kite, doesn't it? Well, maybe not. I thought it was a kite. A sheet of hammered tin. Well, that's not a kite. It's a conduct. I mean, yeah, I guess that's true. I expected a kite to be. I expect me. To, well, let's. Dang it. There's another one, Penn Mansion. They put governors in their stead and they weren't too picky about who they chose. This made the colonists really angry. Some of Ben Franklin's time, London was spent protesting the Penn's brothers' right to receive money as absentee landlords. Ben disliked them heartily and they felt the same way about him. So now we can just go in and out of Ben Franklin's house at will. Because we dealt with that. Ew. Yes? What can I do for you? Blah. Would you perhaps like a groove to groove on a nice leg of lamb? No thanks, I'm really not that hungry. What? Not hungry? Good grief, boy, how can you not be hungry? I'm hungry all the time! I'm too sad to eat. My poor dog has been kidnapped. I never understood the point of having a dog. They just eat all your food! And they never bring you more! But I suppose you are upset, poor lad. Sir, you could help me by answering me a few questions. Oh, certainly! By the way, my name's General Lee Stuffed. Retired from this Majesty's Royal Army. So what do you want to know about, lad? General Lee, how well do you know Ben Franklin? Do you think he'll help me save my dog? I know Ben well. I was a member of his philosophical club, the Junto. He's a cold old gent, and I'm sure he'll be thrilled to help you. Of course, just so long as he doesn't get out of his hot tub. He never gets out of his hot tub anymore. Oh man, Uncle Fred scooped everything up. What a piece of bread. That sounds good. Maybe I'll go get one. General Lee, why do you put up with the pews? Why don't they just march over there and kick their toss them out? Understand something, lad. I'm loyal to the crown, even when they send obnoxious pretty dictators like the pews to plague us. Even when they tax you unfairly, even when they put outrageous trade restrictions on the colonies, even when they treat you like prisoners, well, I admit they haven't given us a fair shake exactly, but if you can't trust your king, who can you trust? Oh, brother. My poor dog Lockjaw was kidnapped right in front of him. You just snatched him up. Do you know how I can get him back? Took your dog, did they? Blasted uncool of them. They got some kidney pot pie. Well, it'll make you feel better. Nothing will make me feel better until I have Lockjaw back, General. Alright, let's ask about... General Lee, don't you think the new trend in Philadelphia is a little weird, to be honest? You don't really seem like the kind of person who likes wearing love beads. Actually, lad, I hate the blasted little baubles. Wretched things. I'd like to shoot them out of a cannon in the Pew's blasted mansion. If you hate them so much, why do you wear them? Why do you go through along with the whole thing? Oh, I've never understood. You never understand, boy. Well, I'm a military man. I've taken orders my whole life. I think of General Franklin as the commanding officer. You see? When he said, wear sissy clothes and talk like a blasted fool, I did it, you see? You're right. I don't get it. Oh, well. It's almost time for lunch anyway. Okay. Let's click on this one then. See ya. Later, nerd. Hello, who's there? Oh, a short person. Go away. I'm busy. I can't get these beautiful coins. Let these beautiful coins get cold. Oh, so pretty. Please, ma'am, may I ask you a few questions? What questions? If you want my money, you can't have it. It's mine, I tell you. Lady, I don't want your money, I swear. I'm just looking for my lost dog. Can you help me? Well, I suppose so, if it won't cost me anything. My name's Penny Pincher, and this is my shop. So what do you want to know? I'm interested in finding out about Ben Franklin, man. I think he might be able to help me. Do you suppose he would? Oh, I guess he might. Ben's a generous guy. Makes me shudder. I love you, my bright little coins. Do you always talk to your money? Of course. It gets depressed if you don't hold it and kiss it and stuff. Of course. You never spend it. Just imagine my poor little coins in some stranger's purse. Oh, poor babies. Okay, you weirdo. Miss Pincher, my dog was stolen by the Pews. I'm telling you, boy, a person has to protect his property. I suggest get a cannon for home protection. I don't want a cannon. I hate guns. I don't want to hurt anyone, Miss Pincher. I just want my dog back. Oh, you can forget that. Those Pews never let go of a dog once they have it. Totally bad karma, little dude. My poor dog was just snatched out right in front of my nose, ma'am. I really don't know what to do. Is there a police officer in town I can talk to? Police officer? I don't follow your group, kid. What's that mean? Oh, you know, someone that makes sure people aren't breaking the law. Oh, those cats? Well, there are awful redcoat sentries all over that place. The place. Have you ever noticed how they all look alike? Anyway, General Pew owns those dudes. They're useless. So is the Watchman, for that matter. The Pews bribed him as soon as they got to the colonies, and he does anything they want. So, Miss Pincher, would you like to tell me a bit about yourself? As long as you're not trying to sell me anything, I guess I can. My husband's name is Egbert. He owns this carpentry shop. We used to spend our money on all kinds of foolish things, like food, clothes, things. Now I've discovered the virtues of saving. We can make a week's worth of soup out of one cabbage. I save every penny, every single one. Don't you think you're carrying this miser thing a little too far, Miss Pincher? Of course not. Ben Franklin says it's okay, so it's okay! Alright, whatever. Later, nerd! A package for Ben Franklin. Guys, how about if I deliver this package to Ben Franklin for you, absolutely free of charge? I don't know about that, kid. You're not qualified to deliver mail. I'm more qualified than you, turnips. Here now, there's no need to be rude. No reason! Look, I'm sorry. Listen, I am no Ben personally. We're best buds, so can I deliver the package? You know Ben? Really? Well, I don't know. Tell you what, if you can answer a few questions about Ben, then we'll let you have the package. We can't be too careful with the mail. Right, Heidel? Right. Okay, sure, ask away. For the answers to the following questions, look in your documentation on page 19. I gotta bring up the manual. Oh, man. We got some copyright protection! Oh, yeah! I love it! Let me pop it up. Let me get the documentation up here. Well, first off, does anybody know the answer to this? I don't think he was he born on milk. I mean, we technically could just look this up on the internet, right? I mean, but I have the manual right here, so we'll just look it up in the manual. At least I think I do. I guess I'll find out. Media view manual, additional documents, alternate manual. Okay, here we go. Page 19. We have a crossword puzzle in the manual, a word search. Page 19. Oh, it's the answers to, it's just the answers to the postal clerk's questions about Ben. That's all it is. It's not like let me show you. I'll show you what we're looking at here. I mean, look at this. Look at that. That's it. Look. It just says the answers to the postal clerk's questions about Ben, and then it's just all the answers. But look at this manual. We got a crossword puzzle. We got a word search. We got Ben Franklin's inventions. We got one words. So we can look up words. If we hear like fatwit, we know what that means. We know what a shilling is. We got some pictures. I mean, it's definitely quite the manual here. There's also apparently an alternate manual. I don't know what that means. This apparently is the alternate manual. This apparently is more, I don't know what this one was for, but this was for apparently a different version. All right, well, we have the answers to the questions, which are right here. So we know that that is true. As it says right here, he was born on Milk Street. Sounds like something that wouldn't be true, but apparently it's true. So we say true. Ben Franklin ran away to Philadelphia when he was 17, right? Yes, that is also true. Ben Franklin met Deborah when he was just a boy in Boston. True or false? That sounds like it would be false. That is false. I guess you are a friend of Ben's after all. Friend, yawn. Here you go. Be sure to take it right to him, yawn. Thanks, I will. I wonder what it is. Can I open it? No. I can't open it. I do notice that it has a little thing on the kite experiment, though, which included a silk kite, a silk string, a brass key, a rubber stopper, some water, and tin foil. So, that's interesting. Here, Miss Franklin, I picked up this package for Mr. Franklin at the post office. It's probably a gob of silly incense or more of those wretched love beads. You keep it, lad. And may you enjoy it. But maybe it's something for Miss Franklin really needs. I seriously doubt it, lad. Tell you what, open the package for me. If it's something that might do Ben some good, maybe I could let you see him. If it's something foolish, you can throw it in the river for all I care. Okay. I can't open it in front of you when you're not here, but I opened the package. There's an electricity book inside. Ooh. Let's show her the electricity book. I'll bet Mr. Franklin would like to see this electricity book. That was a different point sound. Did you hear that? That was a different point sound. Electricity. Ben used to be so interested in electricity. Before he took ill, he'd skip lunch and dinner both and work into the wee hours of the morning at his electricity experiments. Say, lad, do you know anything about electricity? Well, I have been known to light an entire room bright as day with the flick of a finger. Oh, splendid. That sounds like something Ben would have loved hearing about before. Do you think we could get him interested in electricity again? Sure, absolutely. No problem. Wonderful. Come in, lad. I'm going to be gone for a while, so just come and go as you please. Right this way. Come in, lad. By the way, you look familiar. Do you have a sister by any chance? Well, excuse me, Mama, but Papa would like some hot water. Well, Sally Franklin, I've no time for that today. If it's hot water he wants, then he can drag himself from that blasted tub and get it himself. I'm busy enough trying to fix the damage he's done with that wretched doctrine of personal mellowness. Yes, Mama. Oh, and don't you get it for him either, Sally. It'll do him good to stop soaking his hide and stand on two legs again. Yes, Mama, but you aren't going out again, are you, Mama? You just got home. Just never you mind, daughter. That's nobody's business but my own. As you wish, Mama. Well, before I go, I'll introduce you to the old carrot, old gentleman. Come on. How I hate these blasted silly beans. Sally, you missed a spot. Yes, Mama. Ben? Ben! What? Oh, it's you, my little love flower. Don't call me that. I hate it when you call me that. Now, Mr. Franklin, are you gonna get out of that wretched hot tub or not? Honey, your vibes are a real downer. You need to relax. Should I talk like a hippie? Honey, your vibes are a real downer. You need to relax. Why don't you just climb in and meditate with me? I will not indulge in such silliness. Jenner Pew is taxing our neighbors on our very front lawn, and if you won't do something about it, I will. Hey, live and let live, baby. Money is only money. Let the Pews have it all. It won't buy them love. You see what I have to put up with? Lad, this creature used to be the most respected man in the community. Now look at him. You're trying to drive this colony to the poorhouse, Ben Franklin, and Pew will thank you for it. Well, not while I have a breath in my body, husband. Chill, baby. Good luck, lad. You'll need it. Quiz! What did a colonial millinery shop sell? They sold hats and wigs. Hats and wigs. Oh! Bang! Man, we're gonna miss a point, and it's gonna be sad. What did Ben Franklin have to do with the post office? He invented the postage stamp. He was the first postmaster. of Philadelphia. He made many improvements to the post system as postmaster. Who was the Penn family? They invented the ballpoint pen. They were a governing family of Philadelphia for years. They were the architects who built Penn Mansion. They were Ben's best friends. They were unpopular throughout most of their reign.
Ooh!
Of terror!
Ooh!
All right, what's next? Why did Ben Franklin have to do with potholes? He wrote letters to the paper causing the potholes to be filled. Yeah, that is true. Yes! Wait, there's another one. Which one of these was not a British Taxation Act? The Salt Act.